Women vendors occupy temporary market shades and carry on their business amid confusion. Disarmed volunteers disrupt and hold examination for candidates of assistant registrar at Manipur University. People of Nongsun Khul block roads from Kamlok to Imphal and Hongmun to Imphal protesting frequent threats by Kuki Liberation Army. And Sankarman Thapa of Assam and S. Premilav Yaripok win men's and women's title in Mega Marathon 2016. Hello and welcome to Impact News. You're watching Primetime News. I'm Lightning Monica, bringing you the top stories. In the midst of confusion and rain, women vendors this morning occupied the temporary market shades constructed on the western side of Johnstone Higher Secondary School and carried on their business. Since early morning, women vendors of the Lakshmi Market and New Market turned up at the temporary market shade and waited for their turn. Chairperson of Imphal Municipal Corporation A. Nimai Sharma, Revenue Officer Sardam Manohar Mayum, Bazaar Board Chairperson Y. Ratikanta helped in the allotment of the seeds to the women vendors. It may be recalled that the two Khwarambankai tail were damaged in the January 4 earthquake this year, displacing thousands of women vendors. The women vendors carried on their business under the Birtikendrijit flyover and roadsides of the BT Road before they reoccupied the two damaged markets as the last resort. IMC officials said the temporary market shades will be dismantled after restoration of the Lakshmi Market and New Market is completed. The government aims at upgrading the Churachandpur District Hospital to a full-fledged medical college by next year. Medical Director Dr. Okram Ibomja today visited the hospital to see the progress of the construction works at the hospital. Dr. Ibomja also inspected the Sick Newborn Care Unit SNCU and the new labor room. Officials of Medical Directorate and Churachandpur District Hospital accompanied the director during the inspection. Dr. Okram Ibomja told media persons that a report will soon be submitted to the center to upgrade the district hospital to a full-fledged college with 100 students.
Medical College won Khatpagi Hanasu, Honorable Ms. Nasu, Kantobikin and Hana.
BJP Manipur Pradesh President Thaunaujam Chawba today accused the Congress government of misappropriating the funds given by the Centre for the Development of the State. Speaking at the launch of election campaign for Oinam Malesh, who will fight on the BJP ticket in Nauria Pakamlapa Assembly constituency in the next general elections, Chawba said the UPA government in the Centre sanctioned a huge amount of money for the state for welfare programs, but the funds did not reach the people as they were distributed among the Congress MLAs. He said it is shameful that there is dissension within the Congress and they are not even campaigning for the party in the Assam Assembly elections.
Manipur Limai Se, Sri Bobi Namahale, Sri Sakaran Vishnana, Uyimida. Tolumba, Lokak, Libyan Kenan Bawa, Ishin Pukal Pangamdava, Hanagi Bow Repair Tobungamdava, Labuk Ishin Pibangamdava, a Kuga Project, Peluhanba, Tawal Project, Adagi Shinda Project, Lord of Peluhanbane, Pashapano, Lord of Pane, Disakar Selusan Manatandi, Congress is in Manipuri, Mutapanatagani, Nakuipuno, Hindanabuki Pilate Travane.
The state executive meeting of BJP Manipur Pradesh will be held tomorrow morning at 9 at Imphal Hotel. MP Prahlad Singh Patel, who is in charge of BJP Manipur, arrives in Imphal today to attend the meeting. The meeting is likely to discuss the report of the BJP National Executive Meeting and activities and performance report of BJP Manipur Pradesh. The meeting is also expected to discuss the strengthening of the party at district mandal and booth level and upcoming Imphal Municipal Corporation elections. Joint Committee on Inner Line Permit System JCILPS Manipur today continued their drive to protect the indigenous people of the state. In a drive against illegal migrants, in Imphal West today, JCILPS volunteers caught 17 migrant workers, three of whom without proper identification papers, at Lamboi Khongnangkong and handed over to Lamphil Police Station. The workers were engaged in the construction of the venue of the first Manipur Industrial Expo at Lamboi Khongnangkong. The volunteers, led by JCILPS convener Ratan Komdram, found that three of the workers did not possess identification papers, while 14 others had fake ID documents and Xerox copies of ID paper. Ratan Komdram said it is the responsibility of the state government to prevent illegal migrants from entering Manipur. He also said, as the government has failed to do its duty, the JCILPS has been trying to prevent entry of illegal migrants in the state. Yesterday also, they caught about 100 illegal migrants during the drive. He urged the government and Labour Department to take necessary steps to prevent the illegal workers from entering Manipur.
Nasik sakash na yelumi kan kaninga bas yelumi kan gebe ki madu gasule ba madu will pole gadi makoi akoi na ji jesial bi thongmi sing na chali jae masi chapham thuk to bone ba sakana makoi mathau ni moi Labour Department lari moi police lari moi taudam de ba moi na torok to de gi ngasi akoi na chatha bani aduna makoi chungthora kan da saka asina mari lai na koi yelomi kanabi process ji tom dui adu masida sum moi tumina sum lai lai na khotra khona mi sum sum phagar pa lepta sum tora ga dia koi makha ta ba mi pha ba chi khatana ta ba atu pa hen ba khungang sing yamam koi chang pa yabi ba tang do moi tang ji tham ji.
Volunteers of Democratic Student Alliance of Manipur Desam have disrupted and halted the written examination for the candidates of the assistant registrar conducted by Manipur University today. The written examination began at 11 a.m. at the social science block. Some volunteers of the student body snatched the answer scripts from some candidates and torn them around 11:30. The examination was stopped after the incident. About 400 candidates were writing the examination in 11 classrooms when the Desam volunteers suddenly entered the rooms and halted the examination. Desam has been protesting improper recruitment of some post in the university. The student body has alleged that contract teachers and junior assistants were recruited without advertising for the post, and the vice chancellor has shown favoritism in the recruitment of this post. They are demanding that no recruitment can be held in the university until they get response from the Prime Minister's office and HRD ministry. Desam has already sent memorandum to the PMO and HRD ministry regarding the matter. The people of Nongsum Khul in Kundrapam Assembly constituency today blocked the roads from Khamlok to Imphal and Hongman to Imphal, protesting frequent threats by Kuki Liberation Army KLA, which is a signatory to suspension of operation with the government. Villagers of Nongsum Khul, consisting of young and old men, are guarding the village at night along with their license guns in fear that KLA cadres will attack the village. Villagers told media persons about the atrocities of the KLA cadres on the villagers. Villagers said they blocked the village roads after receiving information of KLA cadres arriving at Sinai camp. The closure of the roads have affected people living in interior of Kuki villages in Saikul Assembly constituency. Vehicles, including two-wheelers, are not allowed to move on the block roads. JSA against the torture of Nongsum village by KLA KNO convener Konjengbam Ibungobi said they will impose economic blockade in case the government fails to resolve the issue with the Kuki village chiefs.
Nomai kaptana tanaba khona bi kyama khoi thok tana laikre mari laina ba sing go men sing post ta kai da khoi jingjen bi na ba kyama haijagra ba chu ji phoba kuki misi matang da thoin jingjen bi da ba khun ma panne hari ba sing si khun na invite sel na che thar ga na da khoi yar ga di hari ba lalo ba sina khoi nungsu mari ba lekai ma sa ji da khali ba khlon si negotiation to minna ba gdang ta mayam si am dang lak piu ha na khun invitation pi da na hona jaba matam da chu village chief sing si amata khui saru ya bi da ba government gi amadi hari ba chief sing gi oi ba da gi moi ki lalo ba jing ji gi ma gai da gi solution lama prokta na akoi the Kiba, Kungba, Lady Basikumaji, negotiation of Tongit and Zadal, Tambiragati, Kanan in Ariganda, Kungan Tongit and Zal, Lavia.
Unidentified miscreants planted a Chinese hand grenade at the gate of MS Sorojini oil pump in Kangabok under Taobal police station last night. The grenade was discovered by the security of the oil pump this morning. A team of Taobal police led by OC rushed to the spot and removed the grenade safely. Owner of Sorojini oil pump Thokchom Jadumani is the vice president of BJP Manipur Pradesh. His house is adjacent to the oil pump. Earlier, bombs were planted at the oil pump and people today held protests against planting of bomb in front of the oil pump. Old Manipur Police Constable Male 2013 Badge Association has called for indefinite economic blockade on national highways to press its demand for holding of Viva Voce for Imphal West and Taobal districts from tomorrow. Residents of Langkabal today halted the construction of road after they learned that the fund under the 10th phase of the Pradhan Mantri Gram Sarak Yojana for the construction of road leading to Langkabal Lab on National Highway 39 has been used in the construction of another road. Members of United People's Welfare Association, Langkabal Kunja, Dr. Kamal Memorial Association, Langkabal Kunja Awanglekai Women Welfare Association and Ibudau Pakhangba Thogal Lub halted the construction work. General Secretary of United People's Welfare Association, Langkabal Kunja, K. Momocha and Secretary of Dr. Kamal Memorial Association, Khoisam Dirajit, told Impact News that the road leading to Langkabal Lab from National Highway 39 is an important road and urged the authority concerned to construct it as soon as possible.
National Highway 39 to Langkabal Lab Taba Lambi Yamna Education zone ga mari yamna laina na maru oiba lamben ama oiriba lamben achida sudna mari sunglai laina da ba atopa mafam da thabak achi chu ba chung ya yaro
hajik chubirami ba thabak si highway 39 je sukta tas to biram re ba mi sukta chatna da ba lambi ema da sembi re maru oiriba lekhom thoiba masigi hajujik yamna darkar lei pose masida yam kan emphasis bibio masida koi da haibji yadraga di
Myanmar has requested India to speed up the work for supply of electricity from the 33x11 kV sub-power station after India missed the previous deadline. Manipur State Power Distribution Company Limited, MSPDCL, has signed a Memorandum of Understanding with Electric Power Committee, TAMU of Myanmar, on March 5 this year regarding the power supply. It was supposed to supply electricity to Myanmar by March 25 this year. Meanwhile, official of MSPDCL told media persons that all works have been completed and only 7 to 8 posts are left to be laid with electric lines. The official said they are trying to give electricity by this month. Meanwhile, U Lamu, chairman of the Border Trade Chamber of Commerce, Tamu Myanmar, said they are trying to purchase electricity, but delay from the side of India is creating problems.
We are trying to purchase electricity from India. We, both side of India and Myanmar, both side agreed to construct electric power line from Moray to Tamu. Within 25th of March, but now India side is delayed. So
Pantoibi Housing Finance Company Limited has urged the government to charge only nominal registration fee as charged earlier when parents transferred their property through gift deed to their sons and daughters. In a meeting held at the Classic Grande yesterday, the company expressed that if only nominal fee is charged at the time of registration, many people can be benefited under the MOU signed between the company and the Government of India. Under the MOU, housing loans with 2,20,000 rupees as subsidy can be provided to the people. Representatives of AMUCO, UCM, Pandam and other civil society organizations took part in the meeting. They appreciated the contribution of the company in the economic development of the state by providing various loans to the people. Let's take a short break. We'll be back with more news updates.
Second division I League housing chathariba tang taruk when is enemita neroka fc ga kashmir lone star ga puna lak bi roga support of you on the chair to you gor mangi aisu ngai jaram
mayam puna mak na leng bi ra tuna meeting ta bi ehak singai jaram gi
manipur gi ahamba beautification center mapham sida mahing uring unsa khoiba ariba dakfam phahan bangami tetu mall freckle na chingba su lothok payai hakchang gi ahemba fat pam da body gi hair lothok payai ahamba lakpi ba 100 customer da skin test amadi doctor consultation lemne ingjagan ngas manipur gi ahamba beautification center mapham sida mahing uring unsa khoiba ariba dakfam phahan bangami tetu mall freckle na chingba su lothok payai hakchang gi ahemba fat pam da body gi hair lothok payai ahanba lakpi ba 100 customer da skin test amadi doctor consultation lemne ingjagan ngasimak unaview doctor madhubala laser beauty clinic mg avenue imphal.
Welcome back. You're watching Primetime News. Naurim Vidyapati was crowned Miss Ugri 2016 at the Ugri Festival of the National Institute of Technology and IT Langold campus last night. Jennifer Thiam and Archana Konsum were declared the first and second runners-ups of the contest, respectively. A seminar on how to learn the Japanese language was held today at Nupilal Complex. Speaking to Impact News, principal of the Center for Japanese Language Studies, Imphal, Irungbam Mangan said students were given awareness on how to learn the language before opting it as a career choice.
SN Japanese Academy is a no high kanda. Aquena, Mataukaramna, Zapanda, Esadaleba, Angang Sinsina. Satra Sinjina, Zapanda, like Tam Dagatage, High Bidugi, Maram the Awareness Program. Essence Japanese Academy, Tamaba Matungshita, Mana, specialized training of Mamas, Sasaka, Ani, Tongan, Tongan, Company, Zinjida, Hogi, Angang, Hina Tabuk Togjagidin. Japanese language, Hypatraka, but Angang Sing, see a quenum, Mother Tabak, Hamna Bogida Mukta, Hoy, Drive Togun.
Two books were released on the 12th Foundation Day of Kanglei Park Historical and Cultural Research Center at Manipur Press Club. The books are Wakok Lon Hilel Thilel Amai Lon Pukok and Modern Sciences and Armed Forces Special Powers Act 1958, written by Wong Kim Cha Ching Tam Len. A discussion was also held on the status of science and philosophy in Manipur before the advent of Hinduism. The Manipuri translation of the novel Nilankanthi Braza by Janpit awardee Assamese writer Indira Goswami was launched at Manipur Press Club today. President of Manipuri Sahitya Parisat Thoidingzam Tombi and former vice chairman of JN Manipur Dance Academy Nomaitem Tombi were among those who attended the event mounted by Fiction Club Manipur. Professor Nahakpam Aruna of Manipur University spoke about the book. Now news from the world of sports. Sankar Manthapa of Assam and S. Premila of Yaripok have won the men's and women's 10th Mega Marathon 2016 respectively. Sankar Manthapa clocked 1 hour 5 minutes 29 seconds to clinch the title. Sanjeet Luang of Yaripok, who clocked 1 hour 8 minutes 11 seconds, came second, while Muhammad Amir Khan of Yaripok clocked 1 hour 8 minutes 22 seconds to bag the third place. Women's winner S. Premila covered the distance in 1 hour 27 minutes 5 seconds. M. K. Minarashi, also of Yaripok, clocked 1 hour 29 minutes 4 seconds to claim the second place, and T. Russia of Ngairangbum bagged the third place by clocking 1 hour 29 minutes 34 seconds. United People's Front organized the race under the aegis of Athletic Association Manipur. At least 2,000 men and women athletes took part in the long distance run. The best three runners in men's and women's categories were presented with 30,000 rupees, 20,000 rupees and 15,000 rupees respectively. Manipur Police Sports Club have won the first state-level YIZP Men's Open Volleyball Tournament. In the final pledge today, Manipur Police Sports Club defeated Lamzingba Team Iram Sifai 25-20, 26-28, 25-19, 19-25 and 15-18. Konthosam MLA K. Sarat and MOBC Deputy Director Dr. K. Lokhon were among those who attended the final match. West Indies won their maiden women's World T20 title, defeating reigning champions Australia by 8 wickets at the Eden Gardens in Kolkata. Chasing a victory target of 149 set by Australia, West Indies Eves achieved the target in 19.3 overs, scoring 149 for 2. Hayley Matthews with 66 and SR Taylor with 59 top scored for the Caribbeans. DJS Dotin, who claimed 2 Australian wickets for 33, also remained unbeaten with 18. Earlier electing to bat, Australia's EJ Villani and MM Lanning scored 52 each to help raise a score of 148 for 5 in a stipulated 20 overs. Before we end, a quick look at headlines once again. Women vendors occupy temporary market shades and carry on their business amidst confusion. There some volunteers disrupt and hold examination for candidates of assistant registrar at Manipur University. People of Nongsumkul block roads from Kamlok to Imphal and Hongmon to Imphal, protesting frequent threats by Kuki Liberation Army. And Sankar Manthapa of Assam and S. Premila of Yaripok win men's and women's title in Mega Marathon 2016.